Hi, it's Kevin Labates here, and a couple of weeks ago I published an article in conjunction with Resonance Security about how the programming language that you use affects the way that you view coding problems. In an analogy to the Sapir-Whorf hypothesis, which says that the language that we think in this case a human language, affects the thoughts that we are able to have and how we are able to describe and articulate what we see in the world around us. Now, as a follow-on to that essay, which, as I said, I'll put a link to in the comments, or rather in the description of this video, as a follow-on, I was having a discussion with Charles Dre, the CEO of Resonance, and one of his senior engineers, Ilan. And Charles is from the New England area of the United States, and Ilan is French. And although we were all speaking in English, of course, we all had our own distinct accent. So I have an English accent. Charles sounds like an East Coast American. And Ilan, being French, has the usual very strong French accent to his English, even though his English is near perfect. It's interesting how the French accent in particular seems to be very, very strong. It's very distinct. And we were thinking about how even if two people are programming in the same computer programming language, they will probably have an accent to the code that they write. Now, in coding, there are things called linters. These are software programs that parse your code and point out where you are deviating from a standard way of writing the code. And this covers things such as the formatting of the code and making sure of little bits and bobs like, you know, not declaring variables and not using them and stuff like that. But that still leaves a lot of scope to the individual programmer as to how they are going to write their code. And different people have different preferences. For example, I tend to write logic statements out in a long form because I find it very hard to carry it all in my head. But I know other programmers who are quite happy to code very complicated and intricate logic statements or Boolean logic statements in their if statements, or using ternary notation, in fact, to write their code. Similarly, some people always go for using an increment function that's plus plus after the variable, and other people use it beforehand. And these are all subtle little differences, and they have effects, and they come from how the person learnt to program. So if, for example, you come from a compiler background, you may do stuff because you've instinctively learnt that that makes for more efficient, more compact code, even though it may no longer be true because compilers have improved over time. So I haven't got any definitive conclusions that I can make about accents in programming, but I'm convinced they're there because I know from personal experience that when I'm working with two or three developers, I can often tell by looking at a function who it was that wrote it. And I think that maybe subconsciously has an effect on how a development team in general works. If you have a development lead who has a very particular preference to the style or the accent of programming, some of that is going to rub off on the junior developers in the same way that if you have, say, a Dutch accent, but you live in the United States for 20, 30, 40 years, you may find that that accent fades over time and you start picking up an American accent. And as I said, as for what effect that has, well, I'm guessing that accents are related in some way to clarity, in that if the accent in the coding is too strong, then it's going to be hard for other people who aren't familiar with it to come to that code and understand what's going on. And fundamentally in coding, it's really important to make sure that what you're doing is clear. Now, you'll see some developers who want to be clever in their code, but that always trips you up in the long run, because if you come back to the code in as little as a month or 2 months, certainly within a year, if you've been too clever, the code is hard to understand. And part of the thing that makes code hard to understand is the accent that it is written in, as I've talked about. So it's just an observation about coding. It's not a statement of this is right or this is wrong. It's just something to keep in mind when you're writing code. Am I writing it in such a way that other people can clearly understand me, even though I have my distinctive coding speech patterns. I hope you found that interesting, and I'll see you all in the next video soon. Bye for now.